welcome y'all to our show. Our kids have worked very, very hard since October on this, and so we hope that you enjoy and you receive a blessing from it. Alright, so this year it's a little bit different from what you're used to. So our program's a little about Mary that was an ordinary clownfish. She was pledged to be married to another clownfish named Joseph in the Sea of Nazareth. But that all changed one day when an angelfish appeared unto her with some very exciting news. She was going to have a baby. Come along for a Christmas adventure that will take you under the sea to the coral reef of Bethlehem, where a baby named Jesus will be born. Follow the jellyfish herders and the three wise turtles on their humpback whales as they swim the seas and follow the starfish in hope of finding Jesus. It's an aquatic Christmas adventure for the whole family that will have you singing, "Go Tell It Through the Ocean and We Fish You a Merry Christmas."
You put many creatures on the earth, on the land, in the sky, and deep below the sea. As you and I know, he put people up on the land and not under the water. And the story you're about to see took place completely on dry land. But a funny thing happened as we were getting ready for Christmas. All our scripts fell off a boat and sank to the bottom of the ocean. It is there that we begin our tale, as this Christmas we search for Jesus under the sea.
Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming. Oh, what a glorious day under the waves. The sun shining through the deep waters, the anemones are bright and colorful, and in a few months I'll marry the cutest clownfish in the whole sea.
Greetings!
Whoa, where did you come from? Who are you?
I'm an angelfish.
Angelfish, but I thought angelfish only come from heaven, and if I'm seeing an angelfish, then oh no, I'm dead.
No, Mary.
I was so young, I had so much to live for.
Mary, do not be afraid. You aren't dead.
I'm not.
I bring you a message from the Lord. You're highly favored among all the fish in the sea, and the Lord has chosen you for a special plan.
What does he want from me?
Mary, you're going to have a baby, and you will name him Jesus.
A baby? But that's not even possible. I'm not even married yet. And the wedding is a few months away.
Mary, this is no ordinary child. He will be conceived by the Holy Spirit, and he'll be the Son of God, the Messiah.
The Messiah?
I know it sounds incredible, but nothing's impossible with God.
Then let it happen as you have said. I am the Lord's servant, and if he wants me to be mother to his child, then I'm willing. The Son of God, the Messiah. Wow.
For many hundreds of years, God's people had waited for the Messiah. God promised that the Messiah would be their hero, their savior. Jesus would do more than save his people. He came to save the world.
His name is Arkansas.
Did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife. And he knew her not until she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
seahorse. We got a long ride ahead of us.
Oh, Joseph, I can't believe Caesar is making us travel all the way to your hometown for the census.
It'll be okay. We'll find a nice, comfortable room in the inn. It'll be a nice place for Emmanuel to be born.
Jesus, his name is going to be Jesus.
But I thought the angel fish said something about his name being Emmanuel. But I like Jesus.
Are we all set?
Ready when you are.
Joseph.
Yes?
I just want to thank you again for not leaving me when you found out about the baby. I know you did not believe me and you did not trust me, but it changed your mind.
Well, the same thing happened to me that happened to you. I saw an angel fish.
You did?
Yeah, he came to me in a dream. I thought, well, it's crazy, but I thought I was dead.
That's so funny, I thought the same exact thing.
The angel fish said, do not be afraid, the Lord is with me, that I should marry you right away and help you raise the baby. Okay. I wasn't going to argue with an angel fish.
Oh, Joseph, that makes me so happy.
When God calls us to do his work, we must not argue. I didn't choose us and neither did you, but we're going to raise this boy the best we can because that's what God would have us to do. Obeying God can be scary sometimes. Sometimes he has us to do things that frighten us or even embarrass us. But when we are faithful to God, he can do great things. God used Mary and I to raise the son who would soon become the Savior. God may not send an angel fish to you, but he'll give us all something exciting to do for his kingdom.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Gilbert?
Yes, Dory?
Did I just see a man checking into Ceramic Castle out back?
Yes, you did.
Gil, why is that man sleeping in the castle?
Haven't you heard? There isn't any room in the reed.
No room in the reed?
The poor Caesar's inn is sold out, thank you very much. Matter of fact, there ain't no room to be had any place in Bethlehem.
So you made a man sleep in the cave? I mean, castle?
Yep.
I can't believe you. Why did you just stash him in the ceramic cave?
I can't.
Gil, you can put a man in the cave, but not... You can put a man in the cave. Castle, but not the cave.
Well, I could put him in the cave, but there's already someone sleeping there.
Who?
Oh, just a young couple.
A couple?
Clownfish from Nazareth and his pregnant wife.
Pregnant? She's pregnant?
Yep.
And you made her sleep in the cave.
What am I supposed to do? Get someone else out of their room?
Gil, the woman is about to have a baby. She can't sleep in the cave.
There's no room in the inn.
Maybe we should make one. Maybe you'll give up your room.
You mean our room?
I mean the corner of the reef you call your shrimp man cave.
My baby room!
I'm going to get that couple and move them in now.
No!
I just hope I can get there before.
What's that noise? Did you hear that? What do you think that is?
Gil, I think that is a baby.
Jesus wasn't born in a palace, a hospital, or even a rented room. He was born in the stable.